Chuckles, it's Blaze and welcome back to my channel. Today is day 20 of my 31 days of Halloween, so I'm hella excited. Huge apologies for the weird angle, I'm so low down right now, but if I stand up I'm way out of frame, so yeah. We are filming in my kitchen, there is a whole bunch of mess over there, please ignore that, but we are making some cocktails today. So the first cocktail we're going to be making is the Red Queen. I'm going to show you what you're going to need, stuff like that. I've never made a cocktail in my life, so we're gonna just hope for the best and just go for it. Okay, so you're gonna need 100 milliliters of cranberry juice, 80 milliliters of gin, whatever gin should be fine. It says Hendrix gin, but I don't drink gin, so who knows? We're just gonna go for it. You need 40 milliliters of elderflower liqueur. I just bought this online. I'll link below where I got most of my alcohol from because it was a really good website and it's very, very helpful. You need some lemon juice and then you can garnish with fresh cranberries, but I don't like cranberries, so it would be a waste. Okay, so we're gonna start by grabbing our shaky thingy. I don't even know what these things are called, literally. Like, the cocktail set came with no instructions, no words, no anything, so I don't know what any of these things are called. But we're gonna chuck some ice in there. My ice hasn't fully icicled, so that's not helpful. So we're gonna add the cranberry juice next. I have my little measuring thingy. I feel so professional. The only time I've ever seen anyone make a cocktail is when I've been to Slug and Lettuce and they make the cocktails. It's Jake to pick up the ingredients and he got no added sugar cranberry juice, so this may be disgusting. So if it is, I'm gonna blame Jake. He looks so sad. Oh. Okay, right, next is 80 milliliters of gin. 40 milliliters of elderflower liqueur. It just says half, a juice of half a lemon. I don't know how much that is. That'll do. Okay, then we're gonna shake this up. You have to shake it for, it says till the frost forms on the shaker, so it says about 30 seconds, let's just go for it. Let's go for it. This serves two drinks. Here's our first drink. The next drink we're going to be making is a witch's brew, so you are going to need some black sparkling sugar crystals. I picked these up from Hobbycraft and they're just to go around the rim of the glass. So you're going to need about 30 milliliters of vodka, about 30 milliliters of, I don't even know how the hell you pronounce this, blue curacao. You need this. I'll link it below so you guys can see what it is, but I literally have no idea how to pronounce that. Can you tell? I'm not a professional. Who knows? So yeah, 30 milliliters of that. You also need 30 milliliters of triple sec, which I'm pretty sure is just like an orange syrup. I don't think there's any actual alcohol in this one. It's just a weird syrupy thing. So you could also use this in your coffee or your hot chocolate afterwards to save money. See? So you need juice of one lime, so I just have lime juice here, doesn't give a measurement, so we're just going to throw some of that in, and then some ice, so let's just get going. I'm going to serve these in these little pumpkin jars, but I'm not going to include the lid so that we can do the sugar on the top. Okay, so I'm going to take my lemon juice from the last recipe, pop some of that in a bowl. You don't need loads, just enough that you can coat the rim of your glass. And then you can dip the rim of the glass in that to make sure it's all wet. And then dip it in your sugar so it all sticks to the rim. Wow, that is like the messiest job I've ever seen in my life. There you go. kind of like that, but maybe with more skill. Right, I'm gonna pop those to one side. Then we're gonna grab our ice again, or what's left of our ice. Start with vodka. So 30 milliliters of vodka. 30 of the magical blue liquid. I wonder if people actually like the taste of this stuff or if it's purely just for the colour. Then 30 of triple sec. I use this in the Jaffa cake ice cream sundae when I worked in the dessert section of a restaurant. And then we're going to add a splash of lime juice. I'm not going to add too much because I'm not really that keen on lime. Obviously you can add it to, you know, however much you desire. Not very good. It doesn't even tell you how long to shake for. I'm just going to do 30 seconds again like the last one. Also, a quick side note, I am going to be linking all the recipes down below for you to follow if you wish. That literally made like nothing. Okay, I'm gonna mix up another one and it'll be two cocktails in one, just so it doesn't look so super lonely. Portion of the cocktail and added that in there. Obviously you could add another one just to fill the glass out even more, but I have work tomorrow so I'm not going to be making that much to drink. So that is our second cocktail done, the Witch's Brew. So we are on to our last cocktail, which is called the Smoking Violet Cocktail, I believe is what it's called. The Smoking Violets Cocktail. So the link I put below, my cocktail is not going to look at A, pretty, or B, professional. So you're supposed to use a smoking gun for this, which I can't A, afford, or B, use. So we're just going to skip that part and it's just going to be a good tasting cocktail. Also, for Halloween, you could probably rename it because Smoking Violet doesn't sound that Halloween-y, but the purple colour will definitely be Halloween-y. Okay, so for our final cocktail, you are going to need one shot of vodka. So for a shot, I've just done 40 millilitres. 1.5 shots of elderflower liqueur, 1 shot of the vanilla of the violet liqueur, but you're also going to need a tablespoon to drizzle around your glass. You need either pink prosecco or just normal prosecco will do to top up the rest of your glass with, and then some ice. As the recipe says, you can use a smoking gun and edible violets, but I do not have those to hand, or nor do I own those things or know where I could find those things, so we're just going to stick with the basics for this recipe. So we're just going to get onto it. I'm going to stop talking and let's go. So first of all, we're going to add our ice to the shaker. So we are going to add 1 shot of vodka, so I'm just going to do the 40 ml, shot of a violet liqueur. I could not find this in any stores, literally only online, so again that will be linked below to where you can find that. 2 of elderflower, but I'm not super keen on elderflower, so I'm gonna do 1.5, maybe a quarter, and then we're gonna shake that up. In whatever glass you are serving in, you can add some ice, but I don't think I have any ice cubes left. Oh, I have ice, probably more ice than that. And then I'm going to take a tablespoon and drizzle 1 tablespoon of the violet liqueur into your glass. So it's heavily purple. Bottom. Now the cocktail you've made is for 2 glasses. I'm just going to pop in 1 because I know Jake is definitely not going to like this one. And then You're going to top up the rest of the glass with some Prosecco, but do it really, really slowly. And then this would be the bit where you would add the smoking effect. And then you could also throw in some edible violet petals. I don't know where the hell one finds those, so again, we are not including that one. And that is the final cocktail done. That is it for this cocktail video. I definitely want to do more of these in the future. Now I have my kit and a lot of syrups and stuff going on, I definitely want to film some more later on. I've only tried these two so far. I haven't tried this one yet, and that's the one I'm most excited for. But I will let you guys know down below or in a future video which cocktail I found to be the best. Personally, I think these are bloody strong, but I guess if you're having it for pre-drinks before you go out for a spooky night, then definitely have these drinks and you will go out pretty smashed. So that is it for this video. Please let me know down below what you thought of this video and if you're going to try out any of these recipes for yourself, or if you can recommend a good spooky cocktail, then please let me know down below and I would love to give it a try. Yeah, that's it for today, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for more spooky content. Bye.